del forgery con la acción 347D, right? Particulars are that in the forgery of the law legislature and are not placed with the government of Kenya with intent to receive the first NCBA bank spousal concept mortgage application document purporting it to have been signed by your spouse, namely David Mendes Logan. Tira Rotsi, not
true. Please, from the court.
The other challenge, the other counts. Counts two. You've been charged with forgery under section 347D, as well as section 349 of the Penal Code, that on the fourth day of November 2019, at a non-place within the Republic of Kenya, with intent to receive the first NCBA bank spousal concept mortgage application document, purporting it to have been signed by George Boyere, an advocate of Akoto and Akoto advocate. Is it true or not true?
No.
Count three. You've been charged with uttering a false document under section 353 of the Penal Code that on the fourth day of November 2019 at an unknown place within the Republic of Kenya knowingly and fraudulently uttered a false NCBA bank spousal consent mortgage application document purporting it to be spousal consent from your spouse David Kimeli Mogul. Is that true or not true?
Not true.
Now, in this matter, my name is Corey. I do appear for the accused. I wish to make three applications before this honorable court. Well, the first one is I would request that the IO furnish the defense with all the necessary documentation they intend to use for the hearing. And the second is that the court grants the accused bail, pursuant to section 123, subsection 2, in the most minimum consideration possible. She is a resident in Nairobi and also works for gain here in Nairobi as well. So we pray that the court be considerate in availing bail terms. And the third application, we'll be seeking this court to restrain the police or any other public service from re-arresting the accused on the same issues or the same count, given the fact that the complainant is the husband of the accused, and they are going through a very messy divorce, and this is just an extension of harassment to the accused. So if they intend to re-arrest her on any other count, they can follow the law by following section 135 and 136 in amending the charge, but not continuously harassing her and making her life difficult based on a divorce proceeding that is ongoing in a civil court. That is all. Yeah.
Your Honor, we, on the part of the statement and the documentation, we accept the support. But Your Honor, I'm objecting to that request for you being asked to give a blanket order to the police not to arrest or rather investigate the accused person in this case. If they investigate and there is an arrest, of course, they should not be deterred from performing their duties. If there is a basis for arresting and judging for any other case. Otherwise, in terms of the constant, we are not opposed to the court coming.
And the accused may be released on a bond of 100,000 shillings to one jury. Alternative cash bail 20,000, that she will provide to contact the person. On the harassment, she is advised to report those incidences to the nearest police station.
27th of August.
That is convenient. Much better.